Hi, I'm Mark from L&M Small Engine. Today we're working on a Troy-Bilt power washer. This is a 3,000 PSI, but this one has a 8.75 horse engine on it. You pull the rope, it kind of runs on choke, then it dies. So, you know, being the power washer, it might have a little bit of water in the gas or something. So we're gonna take her all apart, clean it all up so we can get the thing running. So hope you enjoy the video. Okay, we gotta get to the carburetor on this, so we're gonna take this top off and this off. So when we get to the carburetor, we're gonna take the gas tank off. So we'll pop this top off. And this is a Briggs & Stratton engine. It's almost one that come off a Pushmore. Same style. It probably just has a heavy duty flywheel in it, you know. On a Pushmore, you the blade acts like the weight, but on these here, probably just has a heavy flywheel on it. Got two bolts there to take off. Won't pull these wires out, that's what you're on off, so it's there. But there's the carburetor right there, and it looks like we have these two bolts here to hold the tank on. We'll pop them off. We'll go ahead and clean out the gas tank just to be sure. Then we'll take the carburetor off. Looks like it's pretty gummed up, so more than likely put a carburetor kit in that. This has the automatic choke on it and everything, so we'll make sure all that stuff's working good. Okay, we'll pop these bolts out for the gas tank. Like a 3/8. This has that spacer that goes down the bolt, so make sure you don't lose that. Now we'll unhook the fuel line. There, now we can take the carburetor off. I'll take this cover off so you can see that carburetor better, but it has all this linkage on top for that automatic choke. So I can show you how to put that back together again. So this here is like a little thermostat. When it gets hot, it expands that spring in there and it'll push open the butterfly. So we'll go ahead and take the two bolts out to hold the carburetor on there, then we'll unhook the linkage. And we got a couple springs we gotta remember that this wire was on this bolt here. So we'll go ahead and unhook them springs. Okay, we got that one unhooked. I want to unhook the choke linkage here. And I'll unhook the governor linkage here. Just like that. I'll go ahead and clean this outside a little bit and we'll tear it apart and we'll boil it out. We'll put this thing all back together again. Even smells like old gas in there, so we'll get this thing going. Okay, this got out of the ultrasonic boiler. As you can see, it's all nice and clean. So we can start assembling it, put the bowl gasket on. Like that. Put our needling seat in. And our pin for that. Like that. Now we can go ahead and put that on there. And here's like the nut slash jet that goes in the bottom. You gotta make doggone sure that is clear. And the best way to do that is there's two holes on the side here. Seal one up as best you can, blow a carburetor cleaner on the other side, and it should shoot a nice stream out of there. If it don't, that's clogged up. You gotta clean it up. That's what meters the gas. That's what makes it run. So see how the gas or carburetor cleaner shot out of there? That means it's clean. It has to be clean. Or else it's not gonna run. So we'll put our gasket on. Go ahead and tighten that up. Okay. Now, the kit come with this gasket here, that's not going to work. So I think it's these ones here. That goes on this base plate. Okay, now we can start putting this whole thing back together again. Okay, now we can go ahead and get this all put together. So we got this plate here. Goes on here. Can't lose the spring. So we'll set this right here for now. We'll get all the linkage hooked up. So let's go ahead and put this governor linkage on and our automatic choke linkage, just like that. And we'll get this. Get these started. Make sure this wire is on this bolt here. Just the ground for the on-off switch. Up the spring. Just like that. Make sure everything works. Okay. I'm gonna put that new carbon air filter gasket on there. And I blew out the gas tank. And I'm gonna replace this fuel line. The other one looks kind of old. Okay. Push down there all the way. Get a clamp on there. We're gonna get these top bolts started. We're gonna put that bottom bolt in with that spacer. There's that spacer that goes behind the bracket of the tank. Like that. There's that. Now let's go ahead and tighten these top ones. And there that is. Now, I'm going to go ahead and put this on. It makes this breather. Put on the back of the air filter base. Like that. Started. Nice and tight. There. Air filter back in there and go ahead and lock it in place. Now we'll put our shroud cover on. Push down all the way. Gotta make sure we get this put on there too. Well, it's already to be started, but I can't start it till I purchase a new pump. This one's froze up on it. But when I put the new pump on, I'll start up, but it's guaranteed to run. Anyways, I hope you enjoyed the video. Anyways, thanks for watching and have a good afternoon. Bye.
Hi, this is Mark from L&M Small Engine. If you like my videos, please like and subscribe. Thanks.